Growing up in Salford, just like a bit of a mad area. We're a bit different to everybody in the UK. It's a small little city. We like our own breed, man. We have our own sense of humour, our own stuff. All anyone knows in Salford is Salford. I think we're more like a mad hillbillies, you know what I'm saying? Like, everyone's crazy, everyone's fucking nanas are even selling drugs. We're our own niche little place and people are loyal and they love you, man. People do anything for you in Salford.
I punched that door so my knuckles were black. Then the charge got dropped and I was so gassed.
I love Salford, man. I love little Luton, this is what I'm doing it for. Growing up for me and our generation, we're like the outcasts of Salford. They're like, you're the dregs of Salford, you aren't Salford. So for me, it's massive to push little Luton, and we've never had a music culture in Salford. There's no studios. We rap from Salford like years ago. I used to be like, we don't rap like, do you know what I mean? It was me making a transition. Like, I was in jail, I met a few people and they got out and done very well off music. And I was so like shocked. Like, I've just seen that guy here with nothing. Now I'm seeing him chatting and this, and I'm thinking, this is a possibility, man. If they can do it, I can do it. I've got shit to say. But you know, it's not a nice place, man. It's a bad place. Everyone might go, oh, yeah, we're good, we're chilling. Like, no one's chilling. You're in a bad place, you're locked up. I didn't come to be this person, I come to do music. That's what fans want. No, I've got to remember, they only support me for my music. And I just want to keep putting loads of music out now. And you know, I've served nearly 10 years, you know what I mean? Been in every jail up and down the country. It gets you nowhere, man. Whatever I rap about and speak about, that's just my experience. I'll tell anybody that they speak like bullshit. It's a myth, mate. The realest people you think are real will fucking rob your work when you go jail. You go jail after a week, you know, they get on your bird or they take your shit. Like, it's such a vicious circle and people, we glamorize it. Yeah, my brother, nah, man, it's bullshit. It's all bullshit. Better off getting a 9-to-5 job. You earn well more money. You'll have less anxiety and you'll live your life. You know what it is? I just feel like people can relate to it, innit? There's millions of people like me who've not got a voice in it, but there's never been like a proper scruffy estate kid who's coming up. Like, I think people just embrace that. Everyone like relates and they know it's real rap. I love my city, man. I love Salford. I love Manchester. Listen, I want to talk to people, man. I know, like, when I speak to my fans, the way they feel, you know, you couldn't pay me any money what would make me feel like that. These people love me, man. They're writing to me in jail. They're coming outside the jail. They're supporting me. I feel like I've got to do it for them now. And nobody's going to stop me, do you know what I mean? No matter what, under any circumstance, I'm going to make it happen for you, do you know what I mean? I was in Nottingham jail and got on a music course. I'm on the music course now and everybody's rapping and that. And I was like, nah, fuck rap. I ain't no rapper, but I just like to go there and listen to music. And then, you know, I started writing myself. I came out of prison and I didn't tell anybody, not a soul. Like, I just went to the studio. I'd never even experienced it before. Went in there, I made Lifestyle, made old friends. So I met Mikey, was yeah. I'd already heard his beats on that when I was in jail. And I'm thinking, who's this kid? I was thinking of some older man because he was capturing that proper pain sound. And then what had happened is I'd been with Potter, yeah. Me and Potter was chatting about him. And Potter's going, yo, he's just come to Liverpool to see me, man. He's a good kid, here's his number. But a week later, I needed a producer. It's like 1 o'clock in the morning, bro. And at the side of Strangeways at the studio, the next thing he just turned up. I just see this little blonde kid, like, yeah, you all right? I was like, rah. He come there, I was with about 100, man. He just come there and he cracked on. And yeah, man, ever since, my little brother, man, do you know what I mean? Then a week later, I shot the video, but then I didn't put it up. I didn't tell no one I shot the video, and then I was still in that. Making the transition, I was like, oh, I can't rap me on YouTube. Like, it's cringy, Jordan, talking about this stuff. I'm gonna get people arrested. I'm gonna get, like, I'm gonna hot everything up. Like, I was like, I can't really do this. But then I was like, you know what? The world's fake, man. You gotta get what you can. And people put you down when you're trying to do something that they can't do. People are haters. So I'm like, fuck this. I'm doing music for Salford. I'm doing it for us.